First of all, don't worry, this video starts with slow motion. So the first part to give me time to talk is in slow motion. That's not an error. I know that you are waiting for this video desperately. I'm very sorry for the delay. We had to celebrate something. We celebrated 10,000 members in our Facebook group. So I was thinking about a knit-along, something which is suitable for beginners and for advanced knitters equally. And I found something. So what you will need: one skein of a gradient yarn, one skein of a plain color yarn. I wanted something that might be as colorful as our group, our knitting and crochet group. And so I chose a rainbow gradient yarn, Marino Soft. And I combined it with a yarn of similar thickness and yardage with Omega by Lang Yarns. This rainbow gradient looks best combined with black, but black is not suitable for my videos, so I chose red to combine it with red. Depending on your patience, you may knit a shawl with a width of approximately 20 centimeters or a cowl with a width of 40 centimeters or even more. My gauge was 24 stitches for 10 centimeters. And you may either knit a shawl with a width of 20 centimeters with 48 stitches plus 2 edge stitches, or the wider cowl with 40 centimeters or 96 stitches plus 2 stitches. You need a number of stitches divisible by 4 plus 2 edge stitches. You may work the cowl even wider than those 40 centimeters, up to 60 centimeters. And you need circular needles or double point needles, as every row is knitted twice. Now, for this video version, I work the shawl with a width of approximately 20 centimeters and a cast on of 48 stitches plus 2. And it's important to use a needle size at least 1 millimeter bigger than recommended for your yarn, up to 2 millimeters. Maybe you just try a little to find the perfect needle size. The fabric should work out very loosey-goosey. So here we have the cast on, 48 plus 2 stitches, and this cast on when finished is actually a right side row. If you turn it, you see those little knots on the back side. That would be the wrong side row. Usually you turn your work now and continue with the wrong side row, with the first row you work after the cast on. So here we're working differently. Just slide the stitches back to the beginning of the needle, so back to the other end of the needle. pick up your second color, your second yarn, and knit this row again. Every row is worked twice and started with your main color. So the main color is already done here with the cast on, and we are working the row again with the second color. One edge stitch I knitted, and now slip the next stitch purlwise with the yarn over on the needle. That's very important. And purl one. Slip one purlwise with the yarn over on the needle and purl one. Always repeat, slip one, purl one. And don't forget the yarn over on the needle stays on the needle. Purl one. Slip one, purl one. Slip one, purl one. Actually, this first row is the only one where you have to be very careful how to place your stitches. In every other row, it's very clear what you have to do. So you repeat this to the end of the row. And the last stitch with the second color should be slipped purlwise. I knitted it now, but I found out later that the edges turn out more pretty if you slip the stitches with the second color. You knit them with the first color, the edge stitches, and you slip them with the second color. Later on, I will do it the right way. So now, when both working threads are on one side of your work, one row is finished, and now you turn the work. And you start the next row again with your main color. So rule number one, always start a new row with the main color. Edge stitch, you knit the edge stitch with the main color, and now you have the simple rule. The single stitches are slipped with yarn over on the needle, and those double stitches that resulted from the yarn over are purled or knitted, depending on how they appear. So here we have purl stitches with yarn overs, so they are purled. You purl the stitch with the yarn over, and you slip the single stitches. You purl the, I call it them double stitches now, and you slip the single stitches and purl the double stitches. If the double stitch is a knit stitch, then you will knit it. So this is still the main color. And knit the last stitch with the main color. Slide all the stitches to the other end of the needle. This row is worked again, a second time, with the second color. Now slip the first stitch knitwise. I'm knitting it, but later on I'm slipping it. So the first stitch is a double stitch, is a knit stitch, so I knit it, and the second one, the single stitch, is slipped. You always slip the stitches the same way, purlwise with yarn over on the needle. And here you knit the double stitches as they are knit stitches. And the edge stitch with the second color is slipped at the end of the row is slipped purlwise. Later on, I will doing it correctly. So both working threads are on the same side. The row is finished and you turn the work and start knitting the next row with the main color. Knit the edge stitch. The next one is a double stitch. It's a knit stitch, so we knit it. Knit the double stitch and slip the single stitch. Knit the double stitch and slip the single stitch. And so on. And the edge stitch at the end of the row is knitted with the main color. Slide the stitches to the other end of your needle. Lucy is purring into the microphone. Lucy. So now I lost track. Okay, here you have the same principle. It's the second color, so you slipped the first stitch knitwise and worked accordingly. So Lucy brought me out. So the double stitches are purled now and the single stitches are slipped as always. So at the end of the other row I forgot one yarn over on the stitch, so if that happens to you, just ignore it. Nothing happens. So both working threads on one side. This row is finished, you turn your work. You already can see the different colors on the different sides that appear now. You need a few rows to see the brioche stitch as usual. So one edge stitch with the main color is knitted. The single stitch is slipped and the double stitch is purled in this case. It's a purl stitch. Slip the single stitch and purl the double stitch. So now if you look at your front side and your wrong side, you can already see the different colors appearing, and now you work up to 10 stitches when you can count 10 of those big rib stitches. We start with cabling. Now I'm going to show you the edge stitches again. With the main color, you always knit the first and the last stitch. And with your second color, you always slip the first and the last stitch. You slip the first stitch knitwise and you slip the last stitch purlwise. That results in a very nice edge. So slip the first stitch knitwise with the second color. And slip the last stitch but purlwise. So this is the last one. Purlwise with yarn in front of the work. So now here we have our 10 double rows, and that's for the beginners. you just continue for a shawl with this effect, with the different colors on the front side and on the back side. That's the beginner version. You may also work a few tricks in here. You may do stripes by changing the main color and the second color. So just change the colors on the front side and on the back side. And you may even work checkers with working a few stitches with the main color in front and a few stitches with the second color in front. And after a few rows, change that. And for the advanced knitters beyond you, we are going to cable this now and create a sort of an entrelac effect. So if you want to work checkers, you work a few stitches, let's say 10 stitches, with the rib stitches in one color in front, and the next 10 stitches the second color in front, so the rib stitches with the second color. So just experiment a little. So actually this is two color brioche stitch, and that's not too difficult for beginners. So now we are going to cable this brioche stitch. It's not difficult too. And again, we start with the main color. We work one edge stitch. And now the next four stitches, slide the next four stitches to the back of your work onto a cable needle. Four stitches to the cable needle on the back of your work. Now work the next four stitches according to the pattern. So knit the double stitch, slip the single stitch. I forgot to fix the cable needle. Knit the double stitch and slip the single stitch. And don't lose the yarn over. It happened to me. And now work the four stitches from the cable needle, also according to the pattern. Be careful to work the double stitch to differentiate the double stitches and the single stitches correctly. Now you start over with cabling, four stitches to the cable needle on the back of your work, four stitches worked according to your pattern, and the four stitches from the cable needle. So those stitches slide together very tightly, so be careful to work the double stitches as double stitches and the single stitches as single stitches. And you continue with your cables. I got a shorter cable needle now. The first one was too long. So four stitches to the cable needle to the back of your work. Work the next four stitches. And don't lose the yarn over. And work the four stitches from the cable needle. You see it's becoming more tight. And again, next four stitches to the cable needle to the back of your work. work the next four stitches accordingly. And the four stitches from the cable needle. And don't mix up double stitches and single stitches. Three, four to the cable needle and work four and work the four from the cable needle. And now for the last one, four stitches to the back of your work. Work the next four stitches. And here I almost lost my yarn over. And now I put the edge stitch to the end of the cable needle, otherwise you will lose it. And work the last stitches. And the edge stitch. So this row is a little more tedious than the others. You have to be a little more careful. But you see, it's not too difficult to. So now you work this row again with the second color, but you don't need to cable now, you just work it as the stitches appear. Slip the first stitch knitwise, and now we have one. We slip one stitch. And you purl the double stitch. You slip the single stitch and you purl the double stitch. So there's no difference. Just work the same as before. Slip the single stitch and purl the double stitch. Slip the single stitch, purl the double stitch, and so on. And slip the last stitch purlwise. So you manage this cable row. And now you work seven double rows over this. Just the two color brioche stitch like before. And after that we cable again. You may cable just the same way. So here is the first cable with seven double rows on top of it. And now you may cable exactly the same way, but I will offset the cables, four stitches, for an entrelac-like effect. So first stitch, knit stitch. And now you work four stitches in brioche. And now you put four stitches on a cable needle in front of your work. So the first four stitches are not cabled. Don't lose your yarn over. and then 4 stitches onto the cable needle in front of your work, work the next 4 stitches, and work the 4 stitches from the cable needle according to the pattern. And again, be careful with the double stitches and the single stitches. 4 stitches in front of your work. Work the next 4 stitches. And work the 4 stitches from the cable needle. And continue cabling the next 4 stitches on the cable needle in front of your work. And don't lose your yarn over. Work the next 4 stitches and the stitches from the cable needle and so on. And don't forget, at the end of the row there are 4 plain brioche stitches without cables, like the beginning of the row. And work this row again with your second color without cabling. Slip the first stitch knitwise and continue with your 2 color brioche stitch. And after that, you work another 7 double rows of 2 color brioche stitch. Then you start with the first cable again. That's it. Very beautiful effect. Looks wonderful with black and white, for example, or black and bright colors. Enjoy.